The launch of the Ocean Cleanup's first system into the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is a historic milestone. Through our partnership, DSM provides material knowledge and expertise, including Dyneema fiber, which is used in the tow lines and closing lines of System 001.
Well, today we are bringing the first cleanup system out into the sea. So we've been working on designing and assembling and building this system in the last couple of years. So this is a really exciting moment for us where the project is really kicking off and we're starting to see what it's like out in the ocean. Well, the objective of the ocean cleanup is to have in 2040 90% of the plastics in the world's oceans taken out. And that means 90% of the amount of plastics that is out there in 2018. Well, this design of the system is made out of a 600 meter long floater, which is made out of an HDPE pipe. Below that, there's a 3 meter deep screen hanging, and that screen acts to prevent plastics from passing underneath the floater. The floater itself prevents the plastics from passing over the floater, and that floater will be deployed in some kind of a U-shape. And to set it in this U-shape, we use what we call closing lines, and that's ropes that are in between the both ends of the system to force it into that shape. And in that sense, it catches plastics a bit like a Pac-Man into the open end of the U, and then the plastics gather in the center of the U.
So next few months are really three things that we need to show in order to prove the technology. The first point is the basic concept. So does the system indeed make this U-shape? Does it indeed go faster than the plastic? The second point is the efficiency. So are we indeed able to catch that plastics down to the very small pieces? And thirdly, it's the survivability. So are we able to have the system survive in, say, 40 feet high waves, which are not uncommon in the center of the ocean?
In our team, we have quite a broad range of engineering skills, but many of us have a background in shipbuilding or in the offshore industry. So we know a lot about steel and aluminium and materials like that, but less about fibers and ropes and materials that are used in those applications. And DSM helped us a lot in selecting materials and engineering the system and discussing the properties and what we could use them for. And Dyneema, of course, is a very strong and durable material, which is really suited for applications like this. There is nothing that we can copy from, so to speak. So if you would design a ship, there's thousands of ships that have been built before, and then you can learn on build on that experience and use that to design a new ship. This system is completely new, so we had to get really back to the fundamentals of engineering and the design and see what it would do and really go back to those first principle physics. And I'm really proud that as a team that's been picked up and also in the relations with suppliers and partners like DSM, the team has really, really learned a lot and increased the knowledge to be able to design this system.
The moment that I'm looking forward most is the moment that that first shipload of plastic comes back into port, and you know, that's something that we've been looking forward to for all these years, because from that point onwards it's proven technology, and for 60 years man has been putting plastic into the ocean, and from that day onwards we're taking it back out again.